Hear me when I call, O God of my righteousness. You have relieved me in my distress, have mercy on me and hear my prayer. How long, O you sons of men, will you turn my glory into shame? How long will you love worthlessness and seek falsehood? But know that the Lord has set apart for himself him who is godly. The Lord will hear when I call to him. Be angry and do not sin. Meditate within your heart on your bed and be still. Selah, offer the sacrifices of righteousness, and put your trust in the Lord. There are many who will say, who will show us any good? Lord, lift up the light of your countenance upon us. You have put gladness in my heart, more than in the season that their grain and wine increased. I will both lie down in peace and sleep, for you alone, O Lord, make me dwell in safety. Psalm 4. O Lord our God, Father to every heart that calls on you and leans on your everlasting arms. Holy, holy, holy are you, and yes, greatly to be praised with all our hearts and minds. I love you, Lord, and I come to seek your face, your grace for another day and to hear your words of life to me today. I need you with all that I am, please give me ears to hear today and a heart to receive from you. I come in the wonderful name of Jesus Christ, my Lord and Savior, Amen. My Lord, I hear David's cry to you and his dependence on you for his relief and sustaining him daily. He wants your ears to hear him, and meet his need. He gives you the glory for his righteousness, his rightness in any and all areas. His right standing he knows comes from your Spirit to him, and in him. Lord, I know this too. I know that everything that is good in me is really you. My righteousness, any goodness found in me is from your own heart and life that lives in me. It is your glory that others see in me when they account any goodness or right spirit in me. You really do set apart those who turn to you and seek you with all their hearts. They are the godly ones. And because of you I have become a godly one. Jesus, you saved me and made me one of your own. I too am a child of the Most High. David recounts that it is you who have relieved his distress before. I think, Lord, he is in some distress now because of others he sees around him. He clearly says, "How long will you men turn his glory into shame?" At first I was thinking this was you, Lord, speaking. How long does mankind keep on turning your glory into shame day after day? This world of mankind has and is, but somehow David is seeing things that hurt him, experiencing things that are bothering him. So up comes this prayer for your help with this issue. Lord, he says, men, how long will you love that which is worthless, go after things that do you no real good? Paraphrased by me as you see. I can see this in this world today. People still going after stuff and pleasures but not turning to you at all for anything, spending this very brief life in worthlessness. Wasting our lives and our opportunities to do good and to know you and live a life of value and good while we still can. Lord, I see and I too fret over the lives I see that are wandering around lost and wayward that will one day face you and be ashamed. Forever lost for not only this lifetime but eternity. And those who know of you but are not really known by you. Like you said, Lord, depart from me, I never knew you. You know them but there was never an intimate walk with you. The knowing like an husband and a wife have with one another, closeness and dependence. People who are deceived and seem to want to be deceived so that they can say I did not know better. Lord, I too wasted too many years seeking my own ways and lived through many hurts and needless suffering in my soul, my heart when all along I could have walked in peace and security in you. I praise you, Lord, for your mercy and patience with me for so long. Thank you with all I am for reaching out to me and not giving up on me, which is what I deserved. Once more I know that without you I am so lost and bereft of any good in me. My goodness, my right standing is from you alone, no other. You have saved me from myself. This short prayer to you I could go on and on with. We can be angry and still not sin. We can have righteous anger, mad at evil and sin, what it has done to people, but still not hold anger against an individual. We can see this hurting world and what we have done in our lost states, but not turn away from people who need your love in us. I can get angry at the devil but not at people. This world is so deceived by him and they do not know what they are doing and what the cost will be. Yes, get mad at Satan and do what we can to bring those he has under his spell into the truth and life in you. I am to learn to be still, to take advantage of my quiet times like in the bed and the night and early morning. I should reflect on your goodness and be so thankful for all your blessings in my life. That is what meditating is all about, simply reflecting on your goodness and mercy for all you have done, are doing, and still to come. A grateful heart is a secure heart. I am so thankful, Lord, for your blessings to me and for your holy protection and covering over me and mine too. Bless you, Lord, my God, my hope. Sadly, Lord, today there are many who will say, who will show us good. People have become bitter, rude, uncaring of others and selfish. They have become negative and hurtful to themselves and others. I hate to see others who walk in this terrible type of darkness when you are so full of light and life. You are the light we can have in this life if we only look for it and call on it. Lord, I close with the last of David's writing, all about our trust in you, that you put a sweet gladness in our hearts that only comes from you, a sweet peace and rest in the fact that you alone keep our lives and watch over us. We can rest assured that you hold us in your hands. That this life, our death and resurrection are in you and not in all of ourselves. All we are and hope to be are from you. To you be this holy glory, my Lord. Thank you for this beautiful day, for my salvation and my keeping. I bless you with all my heart, my Lord, my God. In the precious name of Jesus Christ, I come, Amen.